बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। टुडे आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ़िगरेशन। इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ़िगरेशन मींस अरेंजमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन डिफरेंट शेल्स। एज वी नो, शेल इज द आउटर पार्ट ऑफ एन एटम वेयर इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर प्रेजेंट। इफ वी टॉक अबाउट द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ़िगरेशन ऑफ कार्बन एलिमेंट, एज कार्बन एलिमेंट हैज 6 इलेक्ट्रॉन, सो इट्स इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ़िगरेशन और द अरेंजमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन फॉर कार्बन एटम विल बी K is equal to 2, L is equal to 4 electrons. Mean first shell, that is K shell, it has 2 electron, and the L shell has 4 electron, and the electronic configuration will be 2L4. Similarly, the electronic configuration of oxygen atom is K is equal to 2, L is equal to 6, and we can say configuration is 2N6. So before starting the arrangement of electron, first of all talk about the shells. As we know, nucleus is the central part of an atom, and the outer part is called shell, and any atom has different shell. First shell is called K shell, second shell is called L shell, third shell is M shell, and the fourth shell is N shell, and so on. And all these shells, they have different capacity to accommodate electrons. For example, the first shell, that is K shell, it can accommodate 2 electrons. Maximum it can has 2 electrons. And the second shell, that is L shell, it has 8 electrons. Third shell, which is M shell, it has maximum 18 electrons. And the fourth shell, that is N shell, it has maximum 32 electrons. How can we calculate these number of electrons, this maximum number of electrons in different shells? We have a formula, that is 2m square. This is used to calculate maximum number of electrons in different shell, where 2 is constant and n represents the number of the shell. If we want to calculate number of electrons in first shell, so we will put the value of n is equal to 1. Here n value will be 1 if we have first shell. So n 2m square is equal to put the value 2 multiplied by n square. 1 square, and the value 1 square of the 1 is 1, so the final answer is 2. So we have maximum 2 electrons in the first shell. Similarly, if we have second shell, again we use the formula 2n square. Now we want to calculate how many maximum number of electrons in the second shell, which is L shell. Again we will use 2n square. 2 remains 2 multiplied by n value is 2 now, because we are calculating number of electrons for the second shell. So 2 square, the square of the 2 is 4, and 4 multiplied by 2 is equal to 8 electrons. So the second shell will have maximum 8 electrons. Similarly, you can find maximum number of electrons for any shell by using this formula 2n square. But nowadays, we can use a simple rule to put the electron in different shells. The total number of electron in each shell is equal to total number of elements in each period of the periodic table. As number of periods in the periodic table are 7, and in each period there is a different number of elements. As first period has 2 electrons, so the first shell will has two first period has 2 elements, so the first shell will has 2 electrons. As shell number is equal to period number, so second period has 8 elements, so the second shell will has 8 electrons. And the third period also has 8 elements, and third shell will be fill up to 8 electrons. Now we can arrange electron. Again, carbon has proton number 6 and nucleon number 12. As the first shell, it has accommodate, it will has a capacity to accommodate 2 electrons. So as we have 6 electrons, out of 6, we will put 2 electrons in the first shell in K shell. Out of 6, we have arranged 2 electrons in the first shell. Now 4 electrons will remain left. So out of these all 4 electrons, they go to the second shell, that is L shell, because L shell has capacity to take 8 electrons. So we will arrange 4 electrons in the second shell, and the electronic configuration will be K is equal to 2 and L is equal to 4. If we have sodium atom, which has proton number 11 and the nucleon number 23, and this sodium atom has electronic configuration 2, 8 and 1. First shell K has two electron, L has eight, and M has one electron. Now, what will be the structure of the sodium atom? As first shell, that is the K shell. This K shell has two electron. Second shell, it has capacity of taking an eight electron, so there will be eight electrons in the second shell. One remains left. This one electron will go to the third shell, that is M shell. You can draw the structure of chlorine atom having proton number 17 and the potassium atom having proton number 19, and you can also write down its electronic configuration. How you can write this in a way: chlorine electronic configuration K is equal to 2, as first shell will take 2 electron, second shell will take 8 electron, and the third shell, that is M shell, it will take 7 electron. Similarly, for potassium atom, K is equal to 2. K shell has 2 electron. The second shell, which is L shell, it has 8 electron. Similarly, M shell, which is third shell, it also has 8 electron. And the M shell, it has 1 electron. So this is the electronic configuration for chlorine atom and the potassium atom, or the arrangement of electron for the different atoms. Don't forget to subscribe the channel and like the video.